That is Buddy Lee, number 18, John Sage, number 73, the co-captains of LSU. On the other side, Dan Schneis, number 22, Jerry Mortaugh, number 42 of Nebraska. The toss of the coin in a moment. Vance Carlson is the referee who will be tossing that coin. He is now introducing Wendell Winkler, the linesman, Alex George, the backfield judge, Cliff Norville, the umpire, Doug Mosley, the field judge, and Robert Ia, the clock operator. The introductions being made on the field. LSU, in the last 2 years, has lost three games by a total of 8 points. 8 points separate them from two perfect seasons. Nebraska, this year, 10-0-1. A tie with Southern California in its second game. They started the day third in the nation. There is the toss of the coin. Talking to Dan Schneis, now talking to John Sage. And obviously Nebraska is going to get its hands on the football first, going against that number one rushing defense. And LSU will kick off. Bob Devaney of Nebraska, the winningest coach in the nation, groups his Nebraska players around him. On this side of the field, nearest to you, LSU with its job cut out for tonight, but LSU has been in games before. Charlie McLendon calls them in for a last word and prayer. And as they prepare to go onto the field, let us call in Al DeRogatis. We've been watching him all week in practice, Al. Your thoughts before the kickoff?
Thoughts are, we've been talking about LSU's great defense, Jim. Let's not forget they're a very explosive football team. Buddy Lee and Bert Jones can both throw the football well. They've got excellent receivers. This Andy Hamilton could really be a great one. And there is Charlie McLendon, coach of LSU.
Going deep, the dangerous sophomore, number 20, Johnny Rogers, along with number 35, Jeff Kinney. Jay Michelson will kick it off. Kinney, 35, nearest to you. Rogers, a great kickoff and punt return man, number 20. And Michelson, a starting tight end, will kick it off, number 81. Stanford, behind Jim Plunkett, beat Ohio State 27-17. Notre Dame upset Texas 24-11. Nebraska feels they can be number one. The Orange Bowl for 1971 is underway. Johnny Rogers at the 12. The 20, great speed, breaks to the outside and across the 35 and near the 40-yard line. Johnny Rogers, number 20. Mike Doyle dragged him down. It'll be first and 10 at the 39. A 28-yard return. Buddy Lee, number 18, is the quarterback. Or rather, Jerry Taggy, 14, the quarterback. I'm sorry, as Kinney swings out in motion. Taggy's got the ball, flips, has his man Jerry List. Tackled at the 44-yard line by Craig Burns, the strong safety of LSU. Where it is first down. Taggy, number 14, is the quarterback. Joe Orduna, normally a starter, is replaced by Jeff Kinney. They alternate a lot, number 35. Johnny Rogers, number 20. Dan Schneis, number 22, the backfield. The wide receiver. To the right side, Taggy with the football. Here's Rogers again, cut down by John Sage, number 73. Guy Engels, 88, the wide receiver. Jerry List, 85, the tight end. Bob Newton, 74. Wally Winter, the tackles. Dick Rupert, 77. Donnie McGee, 70, the guards. And Doug Dumbler at center. The LSU defense, which is a good one, in a moment. It is second down 11 from the 46. Engels wide to the right. Rogers slotted right. This is Kinney picking up a couple of yards across the 45 down to the 43. Again, Sage, number 73, with Northworthy, number 15, making the stop.
Jim, during the course of this football game, we're going to see LSU moving from a straight 4-3 even defensive alignment to a nod. The two linebackers and the man to watch we mentioned earlier, Mike Anderson, 45, Cassio, and Richard Piku. They jam in to take away the run.
Third down and nine. Flags go down. Taggy back to throw and running out of room. The flag is down at the 44-yard line. Arthur Davis, 93. John Sage, 73. Ronnie Estes, 78. Buddy Milliken, 86. The front four. Sage again made the tackle there. Mike Anderson, 45. Luis Cassio, 48. Richard Piku, 88. The linebackers. Tommy Casanova, 37. Jim Early, 39. The cornerbacks. Bill Norsworthy, 15. Craig Burns, 30. The safeties. A legal motion is refused. So Burns, who has returned two punts for touchdowns, goes back, and Jeff Hughes will do the kicking. Hughes has had a couple of punts blocked. Gets a low pass from center. High kick and short. It'll hit at about the 30. Bounds inside the 20. Burns will let it go as it goes inside the 10, but it's going to be marked back near the 20-yard line. So Nebraska picks up a first down, but then is forced to punt the ball away. Ball being marked at the 15. So now LSU will go on offense. Buddy Lee, 18 at quarterback. Arthur Cantrell, 24, the tailback. Andy Hamilton, 80, one wide receiver. Gerald Kegley, 34, another. Jim Benglis is the up man in that eye, as it's a power eye to the left. Number 43. Cantrell gets the call and perhaps a yard. Jay Michelson, 81, the tight end. Glenn Alexander, 77. Phil Murray, 58, the tackles. Jimmy Elkins, 60. Mike Damari, 62, the guards. And Jack Joubert, number 50, the center. We'll give you that Nebraska defense in a moment.
Nebraska does give an awful lot of room on that short down and out. Blahock, 27, and Anderson both play rather deep. Andy Hamilton can negotiate the short pass very well.
Second down and 9. Cantrell, who is a workhorse, picks up another couple of yards. Lahock, 27, is on top of it. John Atkins, 57, also helping out on the tackle. Now, Nebraska would use a front five. John Atkins, 57, Larry Jacobson, 75, Ed Terriard, 56, Dave Wallin, 76, Willie Harper, 81. Their linebackers, Jerry Martaw, the All-American, number 42, Bob Terrio, number 45, with the call of Monster Man, Dave Borock, 43. Their cornerbacks, Lahock, 27, and Anderson, 18, and your safety, Bill Cush. Chris Danton has now come into the backfield. Number 32. The fake to Danton. Lee is in trouble and gets out of it for the moment and is now dragged down by Perriard inside the 10-yard line. And it'll be fourth down.
It could be a big blow for LSU, Jim. Arthur Cantrell, number 24, went off limping, and he's the guy that led in most attempts, broke Jimmy Taylor's record in most attempts, and he's broken Steve Van Buren's record in most yardage.
No score in the ball game. 4.5 minutes gone. Wayne Dickinson, a sophomore, kicks the ball very high, averaging a little bit better than 37 yards per kick. Kicks another high one. Rogers has it back on the 47-yard line of LSU, and Nebraska takes over there, first and 10. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, LSU nothing, Nebraska nothing. And now we return to our studios for this message. There is Arthur Cantrell, number 24. That right ankle is bothering him. Bob Nagel is now in as a cornerback for LSU, number 26. Taggy still has the football, looking to throw. Throwing deep downfield, intended for List, and it is up in the air and broken up. Double team back there, Tommy Casanova, and it looks as though Craig Burns is coming up limping. Burns, who has 8 interceptions to lead the team, is limping.
A little bit of a surprise. A little bit of a surprise. It looked like Nebraska was going to be running the football much more. They will be eventually. They're seeing an odd man line. Linebackers lined up in the middle. LSU was going to try to take away that inside run.
Jeff Hughes has come in, Rogers out. That's Hughes at the top of your screen on second down 10. That is Orduna, who is in motion. Taggy pitching back to Snipes, his fullback, who has good yardage and gets down near the 30-yard line. Dan Snipes, the 6'2 senior, and here it is again, Al.
Here comes Snipes. Got great hands. He's a big one. They don't use him that much. Gets outside. He is a big football player. Mike Anderson reaches out for him. Finally, bull down.
And it's all for naught. They're pacing off 5 yards, takes it back to the 48-yard line of Nebraska. And the penalty is for, again, motion against Nebraska.
J. Jim, we haven't seen the statistics on Nebraska and how much they might use the screen, but they're getting a very large rush from that front of LSU. The screen could work.
Second down, 15. Rogers is back in and is wide to the left. Nagy looking deep again, intended for the tight end. List just can't get to it. List, the tight end, has twice tonight been used on long patterns. Norsworthy and Staggs were back with him as Staggs has replaced Craig Burns, who limped out. Cantrell, we understand, was kicked in the ankle. How long he will be out, we don't know. I'll alert you of something else. Jeff Orduna, 31, and Jeff Kinney, number 35, go in and out at all times, so you'll see them alternate. Third down play, and Taggy throwing a lot here in the early going. Looks again for Ingles. Not enough for the first down across the 40 to the 39-yard line. He had to get inside the 37-yard line. Cassio and Casanova, numbers 48 and 37, helped out on the stop. 10 minutes, 29 seconds to go. Everybody expected this to be a great Orange Bowl game. I'm sure it will be, but not too many, I don't suspect, thought it could be for the national championship. Casanova goes deep. Jeff Hughes in to do the kicking. He was obviously angling for the sidelines, and the ball goes down the right side, bounding, and goes into the end zone. We'll come out to the 20-yard line, where it'll be first and 10 for LSU in this scoreless game. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, LSU nothing, Nebraska nothing. First and 10 LSU, Chris Danton, number 32, the sophomore from Baton Rouge, is still in there. Cantrell is out. Buddy Lee, playing with an injured thumb, remains your quarterback. Eye formation, shifting is Michelson, the tight end, to the right side. That is Danton, who has fine speed, and he picks up perhaps 5 yards to the 25-yard line. Getting up, 81, Willie Harper, and also in on the tackle, number 45, Bob Terrio.
The Nebraska Cornhuskers play a genuine five-man line. Ed Perriard head up on the center. You'll notice that Larry Jacobson, 75, and Wallin, 76, play rather wide. That's to give that small man in the middle room to operate.
Second down, and let's call it six. Buddy Lee back to throw, has his man Michelson, the tight end, and he's out to the 40-yard line. Michelson is listed as a fine blocker, but the tight end that plays behind him, Ken Cavanaugh, is the pass catcher. This time, Michelson hauls it in and takes it to the 40. First down, LSU in the scoreless game.
Here it is over again. Looks like both teams are going to the unexpected, the tight end.
Gagley goes wide left. Hamilton, who can fly, is to the right, bottom of your screen. This is Dana, and he is driven back by Dave Wallin, number 76. That is Atkins on top, but it's Wallin, number 76, who drove in from the right side. A loss on the play, back to the 37-yard line. Nebraska, and that's the Nebraska bench, is a lot bigger than LSU, and LSU might do what it had to do against Notre Dame in that 3-0 loss. Play its second unit a lot. Against Notre Dame, they played them all the time in the third quarter. Nebraska is a big team. Second down, long yardage. Lee going for Hamilton. He's got it, and out of bounds. First down inside the 45 at the 43.
They had Gerald Kegley on the same side with Andy Hamilton. Kegley goes deep. Andy Hamilton waits for him to clear, and he makes a fine move to the outside. Good catch, good pass.
22.3 yards per catch all year long. There goes Cantrell off the field for Andy Hamilton, and that leads the NCAA statistics. A quarterback on this team of LSU, Burt Jones, is his first cousin. First down, Danton has lost the football. And Nebraska has it. Getting up is Wallin, who made the great defensive play moments ago, recovers the fumble of Chris Danton. The ball is spotted at the 44-yard line. First and 10 for the Big Red of Nebraska. The longest run against that powerful defense of LSU, 26 yards by Joe Theismann of Notre Dame, who had quite a day today against Texas. Taggy remains the quarterback. Taggy still has the football. Taggy throws to the sidelines to Ingles. Near a first down and might have it across the 50-yard line to the 47-yard line. All-American Tommy Casanova, who will always go to the side on which the best receiver is placed, he'll flop from his cornerback spot, made the stop. Very close to a first down. Many times, and Al and I were talking about this, you will see linebackers go to the strong side or weak side, safety men strong side or weak side, but very seldom a cornerback. Casanova does. Second man through is Kinney, and he's got the first down with more than enough to spare across the 45-yard line, down to the 43.
The frequency on Nebraska isn't necessarily to see them throwing on first down, and you'll recall now that Jerry Taggy has put the ball up just about every down that he's had it, series rather, that he's had it on first down. Let's see what he does now.
LSU number one in the nation against the rushing defense, and Nebraska obviously reads those statistics. They've been throwing the ball a lot, as Al said. No score, first quarter. That is Kinney in motion. Flags go down, and Kinney's got the ball. And Burns, who's back in, makes the stop. But again, it could be motion charged against Nebraska. And if so, it'll be the third time. Looked as though Kinney might have turned toward the line. That's what it is. Turned toward the line of scrimmage before the snap.
On that particular play, the Nebraska team lined up in a double wing, and then they took Rogers, number 20, from the slot to the right, put him in motion to the left, putting three good receivers to one side.
Bob Devaney there, the head coach of Notre Dame in the dark jacket. And he, of course, is the winningest coach in all of collegiate football. Motion again, third time. And so we'll replay the down, and there'll be 15 yards to go. Ingles left, Rogers right. Kinney in motion. Taggy pitches back to Snice, and he is in trouble. Across the way, there's that LSU defense we've been talking about. Davis, number 93, and Lloyd Fry, number 92, a reserve linebacker, in to make the stop.
Lloyd Fry was on the right side of the field. He had come in for Dave Picoux, number 88. We'll see this quite often. We'll even see LSU go with a complete switch of teams. Charlie McClendon is known for putting in a new team and just advising them to hold for a certain period of time.
Second down, and since there was a loss on that play, 18 to go from the 49 of Nebraska. Taggy looking to go deep again down the field, and no good. Across the way, intended for Jeff Kinney, and Norsworthy, number 15, was with him all the way. And Taggy, Al, is really not only throwing a lot, but throwing deep.
He is. He's been going against a zone, and it's a... There we saw a safety zone, and Bill Norsworthy just made a super play, Jim. He came clear across the field to the far side. Great play.
You can see Richard Picoux, 88, race in, and Lloyd Fry, 92, come out at the linebacker spots. But now we come to third down and 18. Ingles again to the left, Rogers to the right.
94! 16!
Taggy, and he's going this time to his tight end list, and he's got it, and he is very close to a first down. They'll mark the ball, I believe, a little shy, but not much of that first down. Right at the 34-yard line of LSU, they've just got to get across the 33, and now we'll see just how much Bob Devaney has in the way of faith in his squad to go for the first down, to go for the field goal, or to kick the ball away, and they are coming out in running formations. He's going to test that defense of LSU, the best against the rush in the nation. Fourth and one, and Kinney goes up, and Kinney is thrown back. Very close. And they will have to measure. Norsworthy was up there. Cassio was up there. Ronnie Este was at the bottom of the whole pile. And we'll watch this measurement. First down, Nebraska.
Another unusual thing, Jim. Tommy Casanova, number 37, who rarely comes out of the football game, has come out James Early, number 39, has gone in. He's at the right corner. John Nagel, 26, has moved over to the left side. So the All-American Casanova is out.
It might be out, either hurt, or it might be they're saving him for offense. They've been using him a lot on offense. We'll see. Taggy throwing again for Engels. He's got it. Early has him by the shirt. He's thrown down, but there's a flag back at the 31. And again, it might be motion charged against Nebraska. Hold on. There's a flag back at the 31. And it is, again, what is that, the fourth time? As they swing a man out in motion, the tendency has been on all four occasions to start toward that line of scrimmage before the snap of the football. We have 5:29 to go in the first quarter. There's no score. That'll bring the ball back across the 35 to the 38-yard line. And Bob Devaney is not that happy.
And the thing that's been hurting the LSU team has been this crossing pattern, and Jerry Taggy just doing it beautifully. He's using Rogers on one side. He uses it with Guy Engels. Guy goes down and in. Rogers comes to the outside.
Taggy's 4-for-7 for 45 yards, sending Rogers to the right, and Engels very wide left. First down play. Taggy on the quarterback draw across the 30 and down inside the 25-yard line. But the market right at the 25. Cassio made the stop. Taggy, 6'2", 250. And here it is again, Al.
He just waited for Sage, number 73, to get the block. He saw the hole, and he ran, and he did a fine job.
He burns him there. Also on the tackle along with Cassio. The ball is right at the 25. It is second down and about three. Into the middle goes Kenny, number 35. Goes to a first down, and they've got the first down. The ball will be marked at the 22-yard line. And there's that number one sign across the way. The Nebraska fans put that up long before they heard that Ohio State had lost this afternoon. Plus, when they started construction, they knew that Texas had already lost. Arduna has now come back in. Plays a very deep man. He's to your right. Very deep in the backfield, about 7 yards deep. Taggy, lots of time, and his man falls down. Ingles falls down at the 9-yard line, and nobody's there.
It was a simple pattern. Johnny Rogers went down and took it to the inside. He was to the slot. Ingles was going to take it to the outside. It did look as if Johnny Rogers, number 20, was open for a brief moment. Let's take a look at Ingles here. Makes that little move. There he goes down, James Early.
Now Piku comes out, and Este comes out. That is Ronnie Este, perhaps their best pass rusher. He is out, and Bobby Joe King has gone in. That is Rogers in motion. This time he does not turn toward. And the ball is over the middle, intended for Jerry List, who has it inside the 10-yard line. And that will be enough for the first down. Cassio makes the stop.
Now again, Johnny Rogers takes it deep. They went into a double wing from the motion. They're going to the tight end. Jerry List wide open.
Nebraska throughout the first period has put the pressure on LSU. Now Tommy Casanova comes back in and Early comes out. Engels comes to the same side with Casanova on the left side of your screen. First and goal to go. Rogers in motion. Taggy looking and lofts it out of bounds. Engels was trying to get around Casanova, but even if he had, he would not have gotten that pass from Jerry Taggy. Taggy and Jones, the backup men, are something else again. Taggy, 63% of his passes, and not Jones, but Ben Brownson, 65%. Of his passes. Arthur Cantrell, as you saw, was led off the field. The report from the locker room is that they are taping his ankle. He is expected to come back on the field and expected to play again. It is second down, and Nebraska's called timeout as Taggy is going over to see just what it is Bob Devaney, his head coach, wants him to do. And so while Jerry Taggy is there, we'll see action will continue here at the Orange Bowl, and the score remains LSU nothing and Nebraska nothing. Well, the excitement's not over. We've got the Gator Bowl tomorrow afternoon at 2 o'clock. Auburn with Pat Sullivan, Ole Miss with Archie Manning on NBC Live and in color. And then a week from tomorrow, we'll have the Senior Bowl from Mobile, Alabama, 2 o'clock. The best of the North against the South in their first professional game. Taggy is 5 for 10, 58 yards. We've got no score. Second down at the LSU 8. Engels wide left at the bottom of the screen. Casanova alongside of it. Taggy being caught from behind. Fine play by John Sage, the defensive co-captain and All-American.
And that was the first time really they got to Jerry Taggy. And the reason, he went with a five-man pattern. He had Joe Orduna in the slot to the right. He took number 22, Dan Snice, circled Dan over the middle, left no protection. Great rush by LSU.
Apparently, Charlie McLennan is calling defensive signals. Piku and Fry are racing in and out of linebacker. Third down from the 15. The throw across the way, still on his feet, and finally down, and a little upset with himself is Johnny Rogers that he could not get away. Norsworthy is over there, 15, Piku, 88. And John Nagel, 26. So the ball is placed down on this side of the 10-yard line. And it is fourth down. Now, Paul Rogers, who was the Big 8 kicker of the year, kicked four field goals a year ago in the Sun Bowl in the first quarter. He is in now. And we'll try this one from the 16-yard line. So it'll be a kick of 26 yards. And the kick is perfect. And Nebraska, which would like to be number one, goes out in front. On the field goal by Paul Rogers. Rogers, a fine kicker from Rock Rapids, Iowa, has called himself inconsistent. He has kicked a 50-yarder. That's one of the four he had last year in the Sun Bowl, but this was a 26, and that's good enough, Al, for a 3-0 lead.
That's right. It's been a surprise to this point. That offensive line, especially, and they are a big one and a great one of Nebraska, has been doing a fine job. But this passing attack of Taggy, I think the big thing that Devaney has said is that he will go with his hot hand. He'll bring in Van Brownson if Taggy falls off. But to this point, Jerry Taggy's doing a super job.
Now remember, LSU's got quite a kicking game. They have an up man, and they have a little bit of tricky business here on a kickoff, but they haven't got the football yet. Paul Lyons is there and falls on it at the 24. Those of you who follow Southeastern Conference football know that LSU will have an up man, a deep man, and then two men on either side. And they will hand the ball off. They will reverse the ball. But this time, apparently Nebraska, knowing it, kicked the ball very short, swiped it to the 24. Monday night, President Richard M. Nixon will hold an informal meeting with network newsmen in the library of the White House. See this hour-long conversation with the president. Monday night at 9, 8 Central Time, here on NBC. Buddy Lee remains the quarterback. That is Michelson, the tight end, going to the left. Lee with the football, has lost the football, and Nebraska jumps on the ball. Number 81, Willie Harper inside the 15. And that LSU defense is to be tested again.
And most times, the quarterback likes to take advantage of this. Here's the replay. He's moving down the line. Buddy Lee, as the first man across, goes for his arm. That's a fine play. That was Larry Jacobson, number 75. And Willie Harper, great recovery. Big play for Nebraska, Jim.
Engels this time goes to the right. Casanova's over there. Nebraska looking for the national championship in this game. There's a pitch out to Orduna. Snice is in front of him. Cuts inside. Down inside the 5-yard line goes Joe Orduna. The stop made by Mike Anderson and John Sage.
Here's a great block by Snice, but then watch the way Orduna just barrels in the number 30, Craig Burns. He just lowers and just takes off right here, quite a collision.
The ball is on the 3-yard line, first and goal to go. Second man through. He's got it. Joe Orduna scores. LSU just doesn't give up many touchdowns on the ground, but Nebraska has been moving them out.
And Jimmy goes right over the back of his big All-American, Bob Newton. Dick Rupert and Bob Newton take off, and it's a zone man-on-man block, and they really blow it out.
Rogers in to do the kicking. LSU's offense hasn't had a chance to show itself today. This was set up by the fumble. And Nebraska is out in front by the score of 10-0. Now, LSU has only been giving up an average of 8.7 points per ball game. Nebraska, in the first quarter, has already gone over that average out.
Now, here's Schneich leading it in. There's the great blocking. There's an oddity about this goal line stand, which we'll tell you about in a minute. Number 48, Lou Cascio, plays in the gap. Nebraska knows it, and they just send Dick Rupert straight at number 48. They blew him out of there, and it was a relatively easy score.
Kickoff again a little bit higher. Al Coffey is over there and takes it at the 8-yard line. Has lots of speed, but that's not good enough. Olds, number 44, a reserve fullback, a sophomore, knocks him down at the 17-yard line. And Coffey, the sophomore from Baton Rouge, is knocked out, and now Al is told to go back in, and they put in their second unit. And for the first time, Burt Jones is in. Remember, the American Football Conference championship game Sunday day after tomorrow in Baltimore, where we understand they had a lot of snow. Oakland against Baltimore. 2 o'clock, live and in color here on NBC. Jones, as we said, is in at quarterback. Michelson remains the tight end. Alan Shorey, one of the backs. And that is Chris Danton, picking up yardage across the 20. Dave Wallin made the stop, and it's second down at about 5.
Every series is a big one, Jim, but this one is a particularly big one for LSU. The Nebraska Cornhuskers are really high. They've got all of the momentum. They've taken advantage of the break, so a big offensive series for the Tigers.
And they put it up to Burt Jones, who's the son of Dub Jones, former great star at LSU, Tulane, and in the pros. Jones being pursued. Down he goes near the 6-yard line. Harper and Atkins were really coming on strong, and Perriard came in to help out. But it's those ends you see there, 57 and 81, that really pressured Burt Jones. Both Jones and Lee have minus yardage as rushers, and that, of course, means in passing the ball also. They have been dumped a lot. 1 minute to go, first quarter. Nebraska 10, LSU nothing. This is Danton, who's got good speed, and he gets some of that yardage back, but not nearly enough. Across the 10-yard line to the 12. Terrio hit him first, and Jerry Murtaugh, the All-American linebacker, number 42, put it on him. And now we can see that Wayne Dickinson is coming in, and on fourth down, they'll have to give the ball up. Now here again, they're going to have to give it up to a fine punt returner, and there he is, Johnny Rogers. Rogers not looking for the fair catch. He's in a crowd and knocked out of bounds at the 40-yard line. With 13 seconds to go, first quarter.
Jim, there's so much talk about this great LSU defensive team, and it is great, but we have to remember that Nebraska has a fine defensive team, and they've done a great job in a very tough conference, the Big Eight. And so the pride now of the defensive unit of Nebraska, they're out to prove that they're just as good defensively as LSU.
Engels goes to the right side. Kenny slots himself to the right side, and Rogers comes left. Nagy has a lot of time to throw. Look at all that time. And look for Rogers, who dropped the ball. He was all by himself inside the 30. Can't understand that, he says. 35 catches to lead the team. 665 yards, a Nebraska record catching the ball, but that time he just couldn't catch it. 5 seconds to go. Bob Devaney looking on. Slight smile I detect there, Al.
Well, Bob,
not on behalf of Charlie McLendon, though.
Bob doesn't smile too often. His team is doing very well. Again, they're moving the football. That quarterback draw was very effective. It was wide open on the last play if Taggy wanted to use it.
Second down, 10, Engels to the left. Taggy, there's the quarterback draw. He tried, and this time it is not wide open. He's lost the football and is picked up by Rogers, who gets back to the 41-yard line. Great pressure put on him that time by Buddy Milliken.
Now, on the preceding play, Jim, the LSU Tigers were in a four-man line. This time, they moved to a five.
That's the end of the first quarter. And the score, Nebraska, seeking number one, 10, LSU, nothing. Hello again from the Orange Bowl in Miami. That is Cajun of LSU, the Bengal Tiger, and this is Jim Simpson and Aldi Regattas in the booth as we begin now the second quarter. 10 to nothing, Nebraska. Cantrell, number 24, back on the sidelines. Third down and 13. Big play, of course, for both LSU and Nebraska. And Taggy is going to throw. Looks, Engels had tripped, fallen down, gotten up, and couldn't hold onto the ball. Had he done it, working against John Nagel, it would have been quite a play. So that is fourth down. And you keep wondering when LSU, Al, is going to get a chance to show its offense. Nebraska has really put on the pressure. Burns goes deep. Remember, he was hurt earlier. He has returned two punts for touchdowns. And so has the man back there with him nearest you, Tommy Casanova. Jeff Hughes is kicking the ball away. Very deep. Over everybody's head and quickly bounds into the end zone. It'll come out to the 20-yard line, first and 10. The LSU, remember, has scored a bundle of points, including a 26-14 win over Tulane, which went on to win the Liberty Bowl and then clinched the Southeastern Conference title, and a trip to the Orange Bowl by clobbering Ole Miss 61-17. Burt Jones again remains the quarterback.
Burt Jones, just a sophomore, Jim, was a little tight before the game, but he looks like he's going to be a good one. His father was a great one, Dub Jones.
At LSU, they say he's the greatest prospect as a passer since Y.A. Tittle. High praise indeed. Number seven. Jones just whirls back there. Now he's going to run. And is dragged down by Blahak across the way, number 27, after pickup of about 3 yards. Jones and Buddy Lee are not known for their running ability, as I said. Jones, quite a passer. Hit on 52% this year. Five touchdowns, five interceptions. And has combined with Andy Hamilton, who is number 80, his first cousin, for a 62-yard touchdown pass. Kegley, 34. Hamilton, 80. Both come to the left. Second down, seven. Jones under a pass rush. Now's not going to get it away, and down he goes again inside the 10. Atkins is there. Wallin is there. And Jacobson was also there.
Here it is from the end zone, Jim. Just super support and pursuit. He tries to get out. The entire red line is converging on him. Jacobson comes way over from his left tackle, and he's really fired up.
Oh, instead of third down and seven, it is third down and 20 from the 10-yard line. And Ken Cavanaugh, and that's right, the son of the great Ken Cavanaugh, who's in football's Hall of Fame, has come in. He is the second leading pass catcher, listed as a tight end, number 89. And the flag goes, and it could be five more yards for delay of the football game. And that's what it is. You young athletes watching today's game should know that the NCAA has condemned the use of any drug by college athletes. Its team doctors agree there's no known drug which helps a player to perform better, despite some rumors you may hear. Naturally, these doctors warn against the use of illegal drugs by all young people. The drug scene isn't smart or cool. It's dangerous and destructive. College athletes who depend on their minds and bodies to win games know it. Players don't pop pills. Third down, 25, and going absolutely nowhere. Is Jim Benglis, the fullback, as Ed Perriard, the middle guard, who is only 5'9", but weighs 200 pounds, stops him after a yard gain. That is Johnny Rogers. You should have heard this Orange Bowl when it was announced that both Texas and Ohio State had lost. Wayne Dickinson kicking the ball away. As we said, he kicks them very high, and Rogers this time calls for a fair catch, has lost the football, and LSU drops on it. Getting up very quickly is Jimmy Elkins, the left guard, number 60. And this is the first break that the Bengal Tigers of LSU have had. And Bert Jones, who's twice has been thrown for huge losses, is back in, this time with some room to operate. 10-0 Nebraska. 12-24 left first half.
Now Coffey, number three, is in as a wide receiver, and this boy can fly.
He also is used on the reverse, Al, as we saw in practice. Jones pitching back. Has Danton. Danton across the 40 to the 41. Now remember, with 892 yards rushing, Arthur Cantrell was hurt early in the ballgame. Chris Danton has been called on to fill in. In practice, Tommy Casanova was also in as a tailback in the LSUI. It is second down and nine. Coffey comes left. Hamilton goes right. Jones. Time again and running out of time again. There is Jacobson. Willie Harper was there, but it was Larry Jacobson who made the stop as Jones ducked under Willie Harper.
You see, he turns. You'll see Willie Harper come 81. He ducks under, as Jim called it, and there is Jacobson. What a quarter and a first half he's having so far.
There's Cantrell. And he's got his weight on that right ankle. It is third down and 13. But Jones, look at Wallin after him. And he's running back the other way again. Now fires the ball for Michelson, who's got it back at the 40-yard line, which is the original line of scrimmage. Jones, when he drops under pursuit, he goes way back.
He's not, and it's not unusual for this. He is a sophomore. They're not going to the passes that will stop this kind of a rush. The more experienced quarterback would be going to the short, down and out, trying the draws, trying the possible screens.
Wayne Dickinson in to do the kicking again. Johnny Rogers, whose fumble did not cost Nebraska at all, is back. Dickinson kicks it. Rogers calling for a fair catch again right at the 20. And Nebraska will have it first and 10 right there. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, Nebraska 10, LSU nothing. 10:30 to go. It's 10-0 Nebraska. We pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC television network. From the 20-yard line, and now Van Brownson, number 12, makes his first appearance at quarterback for Nebraska. Van Brownson, who likes to run, is running the football, and out of bounds he goes across the way. As he crosses the 45-yard line, Mike Anderson knocks him out of bounds. As we said, LSU over the last 2 years has lost three ball games by a total of 8 points. They're 9-2 this year, losing their opener to Texas A&M, when they lost that fine quarterback, Butch Dewey, who's died suddenly. Then they lost to Notre Dame, 3-0. Nebraska, of course, has not lost this year. They are 10-0-1, the number three ranked in the country before tonight. Second down and about a yard. That is Orduna, who picks up the first down across the 30-yard line.
The Nebraska team has been using Johnny Rogers in the slot to the right, and they've also had Guy Angles to the right. We haven't seen too many combination patterns between the two, but the thing we have to remember is that Johnny Rogers does have good speed, can get deep on you, so let's keep our eye on number 20.
Rogers and Ingles to the right. That's Van Brownson going long. It is intercepted by Norsworthy. Back at the 43-yard line, Norsworthy has his sixth interception of the year. Well, I can't say that. The first of the year, because this is 1971.
Right, and on this play, you'll see that Johnny Rogers had him beat. The pass was underthrown by Van Brownson. Rogers was beyond him. There was a good interception, good positioning.
Buddy Lee, who has that bad thumb, is back in at quarterback, and Bert Jones goes to the sidelines. Ledoux is in, and he's wide to the right, and Coffey wide to the left. Numbers 1 and 3, and they are quick ones. Second man through, as Terrio makes the stop, is number 21, Dell Walker, a junior from Baton Rouge. Walker had a 5.8 average before tonight, hurt during the middle of the year. Kavanaugh now comes in, number 89, as you look at the Nebraska defense. Michelson comes out. Kavanaugh had 25 catches. So they've got their best and perhaps fleetest men in there. Of course, Hamilton is not in there. Lee back, getting protection. Across the middle, it is tipped, intended for Del Walker. Tipped at the line of scrimmage.
This Perryard is really something. We commented on that five-man line that Nebraska is using, and they use Perryard, who's 5'9", head up on the center, but they'll play their tackles very wide. This again to give Perryard an opportunity to maneuver. He really put it to Buddy Lee on the last play.
And now Willie Harper in the picture there, Al, number 81, has done a tremendous job. Sophomore lineman of the year in the Big 8. Third down and about 10 to go. Andy Hamilton has come back in. Buddy Lee, there's Perryard on the screen. That is Del Walker. Walker trying to get the first down, and he's got the first down at the 46-yard line of the University of Nebraska. Del Walker. Michelson now comes in. Kavanaugh comes out. Dave Borock made the tackle. 5 minutes left, first half. Lee is 2 for 3 for 40 yards. LSU trying to get back in the ballgame. That's Lee carrying the ball, and he is down to the 40-yard line. A pickup of 6 yards on the play. It'll be second down and 4. Jerry Murtaugh made the stop. Ball right at the 40. Behind Murtaugh, who is the strong side linebacker on the left side, is Joe Blahock, fine sophomore. A lot of people, we talked to Joe, call him Blaha, but he prefers to have the K on the end of it and calls himself Blahock. From Columbus, Nebraska. Second down and 3. Quick pitch back, Coffey, and boy, are they waiting for him. Went all the way back to the 47-yard line of LSU. John Atkins, the end, number 57. You'll see him getting up there. Played that perfectly. Johnny McClendon didn't like it. As Coffey came around on that reverse, Atkins, who's the only player that I know of that plays with glasses, perhaps you can see them inside his helmet there, not with contact lenses. Atkins was just sitting there waiting for him.
And once again, it's a big passing situation, and Buddy Lee might just decide to come back with the screen. They're yelling, watch the screen.
Third down, 15. Hamilton to the right, Coffey left. Kavanaugh's back in on the right side. Lee under pressure. That's Perryard that goes all the way back and drops him back inside the 35. Ed Perryard, 5'9" from Birch Run, Michigan.
There he is, head up on the center. You see that quick move? Just one little move, he beats the center. He's short and extremely quick. Number 56, Perryard. Great play.
10-0. Well, we said that LSU had a great defensive team. It does. But Nebraska's showing us some defense, too. Rogers lets this bounce. And it is down just over the 30-yard line by Tom Besselman, a sophomore from New Orleans. Now, Nebraska takes over again, and action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score remaining, Nebraska 10 and LSU nothing. 2 million people in Pakistan are faced with starvation, exposure, disease. The Pakistan flood was the worst natural disaster of this century. It will be a greater disaster if we don't care. Send whatever amount you can to save the survivors. Pakistan Relief Fund, Box 1670, Washington, D.C. The zip is 20013. And Brownson pitching to Kinney. Kinney is across the 30-yard line and maybe picked up a couple of yards out to the 34, where it'll be second down and 8. Again, Notre Dame defeated top-ranked Texas 24-11. That was in the Cotton Bowl. Stanford knocked over Ohio State, second-ranked, 27-17. And in another game, at the Sugar Bowl, Tennessee 34, the Air Force Academy 13. Speaking of Tennessee, we saw a lot of bands from around the country last night at the Orange Bowl Parade, and one of the finest was that from Columbia, Tennessee, that was here. Second down and 8. Cox is now in. Van Bronson hands the ball to Kinney. He's trying to get running room outside and isn't going to get too much. Got a yard or so across the 35, and it is third down. Piku and Casio made the stop. Well, Rogers kicked a 26-yard field goal to make it 3-0 late in the first quarter. And then Willie Harper, who's having a fine night, recovered a fumble on the 15-yard line. Orduna later scored from the 3 to make it 10-0, and that's where we are.
One of the plays that's been open very much tonight is Guy Engels, 88, going downfield, enough for the first down and hooking in.
Well, Engels is in again to the left on 3rd and 6. And Brownson has his man, who's having a pretty good night. That's Jeff Kinney, the man filling in for Orduna, and he's out to the 45-yard line, and he has a first down. Kinney, 661 yards with a 4.5 average this year. Orduna, the man that he alternates with, 834 yards with a 4.5 average. 5:40 to go in the half. Kinney has carried 6 times for 15 yards. Now he catches a pass for a first down. Kinney again across the 50 into LSU territory. Down to the 48-yard line goes Jeff Kinney.
In film that we've seen, Tommy Casanova, number 37, has been playing a lot of bump and run with very speedy wide receivers. Today, he has not come up and played bump and run with Guy Engels.
Second down 3 after the 7-yard pickup by Kinney. That's Casanova up there against Engels, and this is Rogers coming out to the bottom of your screen, and Van Brownson going back to pass, and look out! Still on his feet, and down he goes. Sage was the first man in there, followed by Davis, Este, and Milliken. And now Nebraska quarterback fields the pass rush. Well, it's third down and long yardage, about 13. And now coming out is Piku.
And Jim, you do sense a little bit of a change now in momentum. The LSU Tigers have stopped them.
Well, now there's timeout on the field, so we'll say action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, Nebraska 10, LSU nothing. Third down and 13 from the 42. Brownson being pursued, throws to Snice, the up man, and he is hit on a fine tackle. Getting up, reading the play all the way, was Mike Anderson, the All-American number 45 from Baton Rouge.
The man that made the play, however, Jim, though Mike was there, as you call it, was Arthur Davis, number 93. Arthur red screen the whole way, and he breaks to the outside. Number 93, you'll see him over there. Good play by two people, Anderson and by Davis.
Now with 4th and 15, Burns and Casanova go deep. And Jeff Hughes, who hails from Burlington, Vermont, comes in to do the kicking. Casanova takes it and goes down immediately. He'll mark the ball near the 25-yard line. They have new stands in to the right of our cameras as you look. Built for the Orange Bowl and the Super Bowl. It will be here in a couple of weeks. Better than 80,000 people are here tonight. And the record, as you see the time left in the half, is 77,000 plus. Well, the Gator Bowl coming up tomorrow o'clock, remember? Tomorrow, remember, at 2 o'clock. Auburn with Pat Sullivan, a fine quarterback, against Ole Miss and Archie Manning. That's on January 2nd. Then the Senior Bowl a week from tomorrow. The Mobile at 2 o'clock. Del Walker carrying the ball for a couple of yards across the right side. Tackle made there by Larry Jacobson, number 75.
You'll notice that the Cornhuskers are shifting kind of late, and the reason for the shift is the monster man, Dave Morock, will go to the side, the strong side, whichever one Michelson, number 81, goes to.
Kegley and Hamilton both come to the left. And now Walker slots left. Buddy Lee throwing, and there's Hamilton, and he has the ball for the first down across the 45-yard line. Andy Hamilton had to come back and take it around his knees. Jim Anderson, the cornerback on that side, number 18, ran him out of bounds. There's the junior from Ruston, Louisiana. Charlie McLendon, as does Bob Devaney, has faith in his team, not only defensively, but offensively. The least amount of points that they have had in any game was none against Notre Dame in one of the classic battles. but they've scored at least 14 points in every other game, as many as 61. And it's 10-0 now with 2:50 to go, first half. Lee is 4-for-5 for 68 yards. Now they're saying that Phil Murray, the right tackle, moved, and therefore the left side of the Nebraska line quickly jumped to make contact. And that's what it is. Murray, a sophomore from Franklinton, Louisiana, draws the 5-yard penalty. So it is not first down 10. It becomes first down 15 as the ball is marched back to the 43 of LSU.
The pass rush has been very substantial, mostly coming from Nebraska, mostly from Larry Jacobson, number 75. He's that left tackle.
Hamilton to the top of the screen. Kegley to the left. For Hamilton, he has got it, and he is down near the 40-yard line, and that's enough for first down. Blahawk made the tackle along with Push. First down at the 40, and with 2:28 to go, LSU begins to move the ball. Senior Buddy Lee in there at quarterback despite that injured thumb.
Let's also keep in mind when they start worrying about Hamilton that Gerald Kegley, 34, is a good receiver.
That is Hamilton behind the screen on the right side, dragged out of bounds across the way by number 27, Joe Blahawk. But he picked up yardage from the 40, and they'll mark this ball inside the 35 at the 34. But it's second down and 4. Clock is running, 1:55. Hamilton right, Kegley left, 10-0 Nebraska. First half about over. He's going to run this. He's run it before and is down to the 30-yard line and near another first down. Dave Wallin is there, along with Perriard. First down. Nebraska with that knowledge, and we'll keep repeating it, or some of you may have been out earlier in the day and did not see or hear, hearing that Texas lost, hearing that Ohio State lost, know that it can lay claim to number one by winning tonight. At the moment, they're winning 10-0. Lee, he's got time. Now he's going to run. Inside the 20-yard line, down to the 19-yard line goes Lee with Willie Harper, number 81, making the tackle along with Jerry Murtaugh and Bob Terrio. They may call timeout here. They say an official's time at the moment. Charlie McLendon walking down the sidelines, and it's official's time in order to measure to see whether or not Buddy Lee picked up the first down. He has the first down.
And on that play, Buddy Lee was trying to go for Gerald Kegley. Gerald was open. He, however, did see a great deal of room, so he kept it.
Bob Devaney across the way, and now a timeout is charged to LSU. So action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score remaining, the Cornhuskers of Nebraska 10, the Tigers of LSU nothing. First down at the 19, that's the time left. Buddy Lee is 6-for-7 for 89 yards. He has carried the ball 6 times and has 0 yardage. He had lost a lot before he gained a lot. Lee looking on the down and out, and Hamilton is there and goes out of bounds at the 10-yard line. Blahawk was with him, but Hamilton makes another reaching low catch. Andy Hamilton.
And this boy is a beautiful receiver. He's a long strider. He's got good speed. He's very deceptive. And he beats Blahawk here. Just gave him a very slow move. Took it to the sideline.
Second down and about a half a yard to go. 1 minute, 10 seconds left in the half. Manglis and Walker, the men in the eye. The fake. And Lee is put down under a tremendous rush. Getting up is Willie Harper. That big sophomore from Toledo, Ohio. Number 81. Well, now they said they were high on him, and there's reason to be.
And it was a great call, and they anticipated. He figured the short yardage, he could always get it, so he was going to gamble on the pass. Now he finds himself in a long yardage situation, almost being forced to go to the air. They're doubling now on Andy Hamilton, and that's a good move because as we commented, he's really a good one. Gerald Kegley, 34, does not have that brilliant speed. Remember, 25 passes this year was caught by the number two tight end, Ken Cavanaugh Jr.
Hamilton has caught four passes for 66 yards. We have 59 seconds left to go in the first half. Well, this week, NBC News' First Tuesday includes a report on modern-day Japan, a country whose military and industrial complex rivals that of any nation in the world. That's First Tuesday, Tuesday night, at 9, 8 Central Time on most of these NBC stations. Nebraska's Bob Devaney looking on. Ball game is far from over. Devaney knows it, and so does this gentleman, Charlie McClendon of LSU. Third down and 10 from the 20. Lee over the middle to Hamilton. He can't hold on to the ball, and it was almost intercepted. Looked as though Terrio almost got his hands on it. The push was there, but Terrio made the dive for it. And it's fourth down, and now we see Mark Lumpkin come in. He is the field goal kicker. Who has tried 18 field goals this year, has been successful on 7. Lee will hold. This will be from the 26, so it'll be a 36-yard attempt. The kick is up, and it is good. There's a flag down, and they're out there waving it in the middle at the 25. While they talk it over, Buddy Lee is there. Holding is charged against Nebraska. They're going to look at the yardage situation and see what situation this would give them. The offensive unit is coming back, and for one of the few times that you will remember, somebody is liable to give up some points in hopes of getting more points. Charlie McLendon out on the field. Lumpkin goes back in, goes over to talk to the referee. Buddy Lee looking on. We have 49 seconds to go. The scoreboard still says 10-0. Well, we're going to simply go over and see what the yardage situation is. Vance Carlson, the referee from McPherson College. Bob Devaney is down. The LSU offensive unit has gone back onto the field.
Must be a half the distance to the goal, penalty. And if it were, it all depends on where the play started.
Now, isn't this something? Will that be where the ball is marked just shy? Buddy Lee's calling for time with 49 seconds to go, so he can go back and tell Charlie McClendon, it's that shy, what do we do? On fourth down. Nebraska, 5 penalties, losses of 25 yards. Well, Al, a lot of things have happened. It is good. The holding penalty is refused, and I'm remembering a couple of years ago when Kansas had 12 men on the field and there was a long consultation before we finally got something going, but this one is a 36-yard field goal by Lumpkin. And as Al said, it was half the distance, and by the time they went half the distance of the goal line, they just missed having a first down. Rather than risk not making the first down and giving up the 3 points, the score now is 10-3. Lumpkin will kick off.
Sorry, Jim. Johnny Rogers, number 20, can fly, so they'll try to get it to him with Kinney blocking.
Ball is kicked to Rogers' side. Downs there at the 10, and he's got it. And they've got him. Tommy Smith, the reserve linebacker, number 96, is the man that hit him at the 17-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for Nebraska, 43 seconds to go in a 10-3 ball game. Well, I don't think I need to remind you that Nebraska's got a fine marching band. LSU has got that golden band from Tigerland, and of course Ernie Siler can be counted on for his halftime pageant here at the Orange Bowl, so don't go away at halftime. And Brownson is in and hands the ball to Kinney, who gets back to the 20-yard line for a gain of about 3. It'll be second down and 7 with the clock running. 30 seconds left. John Sage, the senior from Houston, Texas, made the stop. Nebraska apparently in no big rush to put the ball in play from its own 20, leading by just a touchdown. With a half a football game to go, Kinney running the ball again, and I think you can see big Ronnie Este, number 78, right on top of him. 7 seconds to go, and time is running out. That's it. The clock shows no more time. The first half is over. Scoreboard clock is back on, and Paul Rogers will kick it off. And remember, the only touchdown scored, that was by Nebraska, set up by a fumble on the 15-yard line of LSU. Now, this has truly been a fine and close football game. 10-3, Rogers kicks off, driving Casanova and Coffey back. The ball will go out of the end zone and into the band, and will come out to the 20, where it'll be first and 10. Tennessee won the Sugar Bowl today, 34-13 over the Air Force Academy. Notre Dame upset Texas, number one in the nation, 24-11. Stanford upset Ohio State, number two in the nation, 27-17. And here is Nebraska, number three in the nation, trying to lay claim to a national championship. Chris Stanton is in. Buddy Lee is your up man. Cantrell, injured in the first half, he is not there. And there is Danton breaking across the 30. Look at the move he put on Cush. Blahawk makes the tackle at the 45-yard line. And LSU has its finest offensive play of the day.
You recall, Jim, as we were looking at the film, we said this boy could hit very quickly, and he did. He saw daylight. Three great blocks were made there. One on Jacobson by the right tackle, and Danton breaks through. 43, Jim Bengals. Benglis also had made a fine block.
Hamilton to the right, number 80, Kegley 34 to the left. This is Danton again being dragged down after perhaps a yard gain. Danton got to the hole very quickly there, but number 81, Willie Harper, was right there along with Ed Perriard, the middle guard. And it'll be second down and 9 from the 46 of LSU.
And the thing we have not seen is LSU attacking directly at Perriard. We've been indicating that Perriard is very mobile, moving around the center. You might have better luck attacking that kind of a play.
Danton has carried the ball 9 times now for 32 yards. That's Danton slotting himself left. Buddy Lee drawing it deep for Hamilton, who's there with Blahawk, and it's just off his fingertips at the 18-yard line. Blahawk, number 27, there to help break it up, intended for Andy Hamilton. On second and 9, Buddy Lee went to the bomb.
I think we might see later in the football game, now they realize that not only Blahawk covering, but Bill Cush, number 24, is going to come over and double. What we might see Buddy Lee do is to send this fine receiver down deep and then take it to the outside.
10-3 Nebraska early in the third quarter. Lee is 7-for-10 for 100 yards. All receivers to the right. Lee rolling to the right. Lee flooding and looking and overthrows everybody. Flag goes down. Kegley was back there, and holding may have been charged. Another penalty charged against the Cornhuskers of Nebraska. And that'll give them, meaning LSU, a first down inside the 35 at the 32-yard line. LSU 9-2 on the year. They are the Southeastern Conference champions. Nebraska, the champions of the Big 8. Number 3 ranked, Kegley goes to the left. Benglis 43, Danton 32, the setbacks. That is Danton. Does he hit that hole fast across the 20? Down to the 15-yard line goes Chris Danton with Bill Cush, number 24, making the tackle. First down at the 15.
Exact same play to the opposite side. Jim Benglis takes it to the outside, and he really pops. Look at this man go. That's determination.
Pat Morrell comes in. Terrio goes out at the weak side linebacker spot. Morrell's number is 40 for Nebraska. Lee hands to Danton, and look at him be driven down. Dave Wallin, who is having a great ball game, number 76, makes the stop. A loss back to the 17, and it is second down and 12. Danton has carried the ball 11 times for 48 yards.
Wallin, 6'2", 238, made a big play.
13 minutes, 8 seconds left to go in the third quarter as Andy Hamilton comes to the right. Dario's back in, Morrell is out. Buddy Lee, trying to get away, does across the 15. He's down across the 10, down to the 7-yard line. Buddy Lee. We pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC television network. Third down and 2 from the 7. Hamilton to the left. Power eye to the right. Danton slips as he hits the line of scrimmage. Tried to cut back and slipped. And there's a loss on the play back to the 8. Now it is third down and 3. Make that fourth down and 3, and so Mark Lumpkin is coming on the field. He has a field goal of 36 yards. Buddy Lee to hold. This one will be from the 14. So it'll be a 24-yard attempt. The kick is up, and it is good. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score now, Nebraska 10, LSU 6. We're having a super day today, but we've got a super special weekend coming up January 16th and 17th. The Bing Crosby Pro-Am on Saturday the 16th from 6 to 7 o'clock in the evening. Then the next day, A Man Named Lombardi, a documentary on the life of the late Vince Lombardi at 12:30 Eastern Time, followed by the Super Bowl at 1:30, and back for the final round of the Bing Crosby at 5:30. And now, Lumpkin kicks off. Jeff Kinney to the 15, and down he goes as he gets to the 19-yard line. And Nebraska goes on offense. Pepper Rutland, number 41, cut down Jeff Kinney. Rutland, a reserve linebacker from Baton Rouge.
Charlie McClendon's discussion at halftime paid off. Those slants worked extremely well. Now let's see what Nebraska does. Here it is again. We've got him. That's Rutland. Rutland following PQ. PQ's a linebacker. He showed really fine speed. Both men down very well.
Taggy is back in and hands the ball off to Orduna, number 31. Joe and Jeff Kinney alternate. Taggy went most of the first half, but Van Brownson came on to spell it. The first half, Orduna only carried the ball 4 times. Second down, 4. There goes Orduna again, and talking about hitting that hole fast. Al, as we did about Chris Danton, Joe Orduna can hit the hole fast, and he's got a first down out across the 30. Greg Burns came up to make the tackle.
And Jim, generally when a team can establish that running attack, it's amazing how well the passing game goes.
Tommy Smith, sophomore from Brookhaven, Mississippi, number 96, is now the middle linebacker. Cassio is taking a rest. First down play. That is Tacky still with the football and on his way across the 40 and has another first down. Out to the 43-yard line. Sage and Casanova made the stop. That was a bootleg all the way by Jerry Tacky. First down, 10-6 the score. Nebraska got all 10 of its points in the first quarter. LSU got a field goal in the second, another in the third. Mike Doyle has now come in at left end. There goes Orduna again, that quick opener. Well, Al, he may play deep in that eye, but he sure gets to the line in a hurry. Tommy Smith made the tackle.
Let's watch him hit in here. He really explodes. Now, they're going to be tightening up LSU, so the outside stuff will begin to open. He's a driver.
Ball is at the 48-yard line of Nebraska. It is second down and five. With Guy Ingles coming to the left. Well, the man fell down. Taggy turned around to hand off, and Orduna simply fell down trying to get started toward the line of scrimmage. And so that'll cost him a down. Sage and Anderson put Taggy down. And it's third down and still about five. So now Kinney comes in, and Orduna will go out. Orduna's now carried the ball seven times for 36 yards. Ingles goes to the right. Rogers slotted right. Flags go down. Taggy back. Taggy throws across the line of scrimmage to the 43-yard line. Now Johnny Rogers, Norsworthy is there with him, but there's a flag back on the 40. And again, there's a legal motion. It's about the fifth time in the game, four times in the first half, that Nebraska was charged with a legal motion. And recall, if you will, when LSU got its second score in this half, a pass interference penalty set it up.
The point about the LSU Tigers, we'll repeat, that defensive line, Arthur Davis, 93, is 5'11 and only 190 pounds. Buddy Milliken, 86, is 6 foot, and he's only 200 pounds. The bigger boys are inside. Estee, 6'1, 225, 6'3 for Sage, 221. They've got good speed. They can get to the passer. When they do, Davis and Milliken are really pushing.
John Nagel, 26, has replaced Jim Early at a corner. Third down play. No flags. Taggy back. Taggy throwing. It is intercepted by Norsworthy across the field, and LSU gets a break at its own 48-yard line. First and 10 for the Tigers, who are out in front, 10-6. That is the sixth interception for Norsworthy.
And it's his second interception here. You'll see Sage put big rush on, and there's the interception. That's beautiful, just perfect timing.
Make that his seventh for the season, his second of this year in this game, Al. 9 minutes, 18 seconds to go, third quarter. Buddy Lee remains the quarterback. Andy Hamilton comes to the right. Danton dragged down by Perriard, number 56, the middle guard, as he hits to midfield. Well, Nebraska uses a lot of people, and so does LSU. Many times, LSU will ship two, three, four men on each play. Kegley's now coming in. As Charlie McLendon says, he'll play 50 to 55 men. They tell the Tigers of LSU, if you got a uniform on, you're most likely going to play. Buddy Lee, back, throwing, caught. Andy Hamilton has another reception. And one of the real cheerleaders of football, Charlie McLendon, is along the sidelines. Blahawk was covered.
And they saw Joe Blahawk man-on-man in the previous play, and they went, and here we are. A replay. Andy Hamilton, another fine move on Blahawk.
Ball is on the 36-yard line. Kegley left, Hamilton right. First down. Quick count this time. That is Danton hitting the hole and getting inside the 35, down to the 33. A gain of three. It'll be second down and seven. 8:20 to go.
We had mentioned earlier, Jim, that Bill Cush is number 24, is picking up Andy Hamilton's down and in move, the post pattern. So they're going down and out, but Blahawk is going to have to cover this man. As we indicated, he's very deceptive and he can beat you deep.
Bob Devaney of Nebraska looking on. His team at one time led 10-0. Buddy Lee under a tremendous rush throws and not able to hold on to it as Chris Danton juggled it as he went out of bounds on the 27-yard line. Tremendous pressure put on by Larry Jacobson and Ed Perriard. Danton has carried the ball 14 times for 55 yards. That time couldn't hold on to the football. It'll be third down and seven. Well, Ohio State knew this afternoon that Texas had lost. Had it won over Stanford, it would have been number one, but did not win. And now Nebraska knows it could be number one if it beats LSU. They're in a scramble. Buddy Lee throwing and not able to hold on to it. Right at the sidelines is Andy Hamilton. And Joe Blahawk again gets the assignment of being with him. That's quite an assignment to hand a 5 foot 10 inch 175-pound sophomore. But he has had six interceptions. And along the sidelines, they're asking, well, you can see what they're asking.
Jim, one of the problems with the LSU attack has been the fact that their fullback is a sophomore. We'll get back in a moment.
Dickinson in to kick, and he'll kick this ball right into the end zone, and it bounds out of the end zone, and so Nebraska has held and now has the football itself, first and 10 on its own 20. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, Nebraska 10, LSU 6. First down from the 20. That is Rogers in motion. The pitch out to Kenny across the way, and he is gang tackled after about a yard gain. Everybody from LSU is over there. Burns, Anderson, Nagel. By the way, speaking of the Winter Olympic Games as we were, that's another NBC special coming up. February 1972, live and in color. Lloyd Fry comes dashing in, apparently, as we said, bringing in defensive signals and replacing Richard Piku as he comes in. It is second down 9. Daggy has thrown 14 times, completed 6 for 74 yards. And he's going to throw again. Screen set up on that side and not going anywhere is Johnny Rogers. That's not quite the assumption to make. He did pick up 2 or 3 yards, but it is third down and about 5.
And right now, Taggy's getting a little concerned about going toward that middle because Norsworthy and Craig Burns are very fine there. He had some success early. Two completions to Guy Engels, 88. Guy going downfield and hooking to the inside. We might look for that.
Engels comes to the near side, and Rogers is slotted to the near side on third down. Taggy looking to throw. Rogers is down here by himself, has the ball, and backs out of bounds. First down at the 48-yard line. Fry was the linebacker entrusted with Johnny Rogers, the nearest man to him. First down for Nebraska at the 48.
Fine cross pattern, Jim. Downfield when Guy Engels took it to the inside. Johnny Rogers took it to the outside in good position, good completion.
6:24 to go. Third quarter, 10-6 Nebraska. Engels goes to the right. First down at the 48. Taggy looking to run. Gets away from one man and down near the 40-yard line. Arthur Davis missed the tackle. Back at the 47. Taggy gets down to the 41 where Mike Anderson makes the stop.
Again, a great gambling situation. A good one to go with the pass. Third and relatively short yardage, about 3. So we might look for an all-the-way tight pass.
Second down and 3. As Engels comes left, that is Jeff Kinney, and there are his statistics. Kenny's got the ball again as flags are down again. Kenny gets inside the 40, very close to the first down. But there is an indication that Nebraska again is going to be penalized. It was second down and 3, and this will make it second down again and about 7 for offside. Again, you see Richard Piku come in and Lloyd Fry come out. Engels to the right. Casanova's over there with it. Long count. Taggy still has the football. Taggy looks over the middle, and it is almost intercepted by Norsworthy again, number 15, making a diving attempt. Bill Norsworthy, the honorable mention All-American from New Orleans. And now it is third and a long 7. Woody Cox dashes on, another wide receiver with the play. Engels goes out, Cox goes to the right. Rogers is wide left. Taggy blitzes on. He gets the ball away, and it's off the hands of Kinney. Helping to break it up was Craig Burns, who is just now getting up from his spot on the 40-yard line. Cassio is the man blitzing.
They were coming from the double wing, Jim, and they actually had a double blitz on. Anderson from the left side, Cassio from the right.
Well, Burns, who returned the punt of 90 yards for a touchdown against Mississippi State and 61 yards against Ole Miss for a touchdown, is back as Jeff Hughes will punt to him. hits and will go out of bounds, looks like, and does, inside the 10-yard line at about the 9.5. So LSU is back way up in this 10-6 ball game. Burt Jones has come in now. Jones, the quarterback, was in the first half but had a rough time of it. We'll see what he does now. Action will continue at the Orange Bowl. The score, Nebraska 10, LSU 6. LSU's ball first down from their own 10-yard line. An Orange Bowl record crowd of 80,699 looking on. 10-6 the score, third quarter. Burt Jones back, and he's going to pass from his own goal line. Goes deep for Hamilton. Back there, and it's off his hand. Again, Joe Blahock was back there to cover Andy Hamilton.
Once again, Ed Perriard made a great charge, and here he is, Andy Hamilton, that's not Perriard, going deep. Good coverage here by Blahock. It was almost there.
Well, as I said, Jones and Hamilton are first cousins, and they have hooked up on a 62-yard touchdown pass, but LSU shows its willingness also to gamble. Gagley goes left, Hamilton right. Del Walker up the middle, across the 15, across the 20, first down as he hits to the 23, and a flag goes down at the 23-yard line. LSU starts walking backwards. Vance Carlson, the referee, makes the signal. Clipping is the penalty. By the way, if you like tonight's ball game, and I'm certain that you do, remember we've got another ball game tomorrow at 2 o'clock Eastern time. That'll be the Gator Bowl with a couple more Southeastern Conference teams, Auburn and Ole Miss. Another fine run of Del Walker. Goes back to the 12 as there's a clip on the play.
Jim, we had mentioned earlier about the fullback position. Jim Benglis, number 43, he is a sophomore. He's in there, does not have a great deal of experience. The running attack really had been revolving around Cantrell, and right now it's Danton. It's Walker, 21.
Well, Benglis was a linebacker as a freshman. Here he is as a sophomore, and he's a fullback. There goes Del Walker again, and as he got some speed as he picks up the first down. Dale Cush makes the tackle. Walker, remember, we told you had a 5.8 average, and Al and I wondered why he wasn't in the units that we saw working out. We were told that he had been hurt. They began to work him out, and Del Walker, the junior from Baton Rouge, has had quite a few runs here, Al. Came right back with Walker again. Morrell has gone in as a weak side linebacker for Nebraska, and Terrio has come out. From the 21 on first down, and Walker gets the call again and picks up four or five more yards. Dave Morrock, the monster man, number 43, makes the tackle. 4:37 to go, third quarter, Nebraska 10, LSU 6.
And on that particular play, Jim, the lead man, Benglis, is doing a fine job of blocking, but a lot of credit has got to go to Glenn Alexander, 77, and Phil Murray, 58, the two offensive tackles.
Second down and seven. Walker scared the ball four times for 25 yards. Burt Jones, the down and out, and too far out, outside, intended for Andy Hamilton with Joe Blahock right there. John Atkins was pressuring Jones, who comes from Ruston, Louisiana. Now there's a good look at Burt. He's 6'3", 205, 19-year-old sophomore. Here he is in the Orange Bowl, and around Baton Rouge, they're saying that he is going to be a great one. Hamilton right, Kingley left. Third down, seven. Jones, screen, up comes the man, reading it perfectly. It's the monster man, Morrock, and what a play he made at the 20-yard line. Dave Morrock, the senior from Clarendon, Pennsylvania, was waiting for Del Walker.
Morrock made a good play. The lead tackle, Phil Murray, was not able to get out there, number 58. You see, he's trying to get, not good enough. Morrock, great play.
Now it is fourth down and 11. And in to do the kicking is Wayne Dickinson. Well, the coverage is there. Bounced by Johnny Rogers. He's going to pick it up, and he's going to go down inside the 30-yard line at about the 33-yard line. Remember, on Sunday, here live and in color on NBC, we've got the American Football Conference Championship game, and everybody knows the teams in that one. The Oakland Raiders against the Baltimore Colts. Watch it at 2 o'clock Eastern time here on NBC. And remember, on the 17th, the Super Bowl from the same Orange Bowl stadium on NBC. From the 34, Engels goes to the right, Rogers to the left. Nebraska holding on to a four-point lead in the third quarter. That's Taggy at quarterback. That's Orduna in motion. Taggy with the football, and he is simply carrying the football. Gets around the end, tripped up by Casanova with Burns to help out. That's the first down across the 45 to the 46-yard line. Early and Nagel continue to alternate at a cornerback spot. And now we see it as Tommy Casanova that is coming out, the All-American. Engels goes to the right. Taggy's carried the ball himself seven times and has nearly 35 yards. Taggy with the football under pressure. Now gets it away, deep intended for Engels. And what a catch! He dropped the ball after he got there. It is incomplete. Engels had the football, and as he was smashed to the ground, he dropped it. Nagel was defending.
Johnny Wood put a great rush on it, but let's watch Engels showing good speed and great determination. Here comes Nagel, stride for stride with him. He's open, got him by about a yard, as you see.
And there it goes before he hit the ground. Second down and 10. Casanova is back in, and Nagel has now switched to the right corner. Early has come out. Taggy falls down. Ronnie Estee, number 78. John Sage, 73 right there. But Jerry Taggy, the junior from Green Bay, Wisconsin. He told us earlier this week at practice, living in a town like Green Bay, he just grew up living, eating, breathing, sleeping football. That's what he wants. Third down and 14. The LSU band.
Let's go, Mickey. Get out the ball.
Engels right, Rogers left. Taggy on third down. Going long, intended for Rogers. Nagel is back with him, and Nagel knocks it down. John Nagel, the junior from Gloucester, Mississippi, makes the play. And it's fourth down and 14.
Nagel makes a great play on this particular play. He's right there all the way, looking back at the football. The ball is lofted kind of high.
Jeff Hughes in to do the kicking, standing inside his own 30. Burns, and now Casanova joins him in twin safeties. Burns does not call for a fair catch and has to fall on the football as he dropped it right at the 25-yard line, where it'll be first and 10 for LSU. 2 minutes to go, third quarter.
And I'm sure, Jim, that Nebraska doesn't mind the shorter punt, because Burns and Casanova have carried for four touchdowns on punts, two each.
The Big Red of Nebraska on your right, the Tigers of LSU on your left. High formation, and now Michelson takes a spot at tight end on the left. Buddy Lee is back in, hands to a second man through. That is Danton. And he picks up perhaps a yard. Atkins right there. Ed Perriard. It's second down and 9.
We indicated early that both teams were using their tight end very well. List for Nebraska, Jay Michelson, 81 for LSU.
Now Coffey and Hamilton both go to the left. Lee. Under a rush, aims for Hamilton, and he just can't get it at the 45-yard line. Lee is now 8 for 14 for 113 yards. Willie Harper was the man putting the pressure on quarterback Buddy Lee. With 1:21 to go in the third quarter.
An And on that cross pattern, you saw number three, Al Coffey, going down on the fly. Andy Hamilton taking it down and out. Ken Cavanaugh Jr. going in now for Jay Michelson. But the point was that Coffey on that fly had quite a few steps when he was open.
You saw Cage and the little Tiger there. You should have seen the pictures in the Miami papers when Charlie McLennan, the Tiger coach, picked him up on his arrival here. Buddy Lee, third down. Firing, has Hamilton, he has got the ball. Across the 45 to the 46-yard line. There is the receiver, a junior from Ruston, Georgia. LSU continues to come back. Nebraska trying to win tonight. To lay claim to title of being number one in the nation. They've not lost a game, they have tied a game with Southern Cal. First down, Lee keeping the ball and getting into LSU territory at the 49-yard line. Blahawk is on top of it. And there's a flag down at the 49. And they're talking to Dave Wallin. They're stepping it up. 15 yards. Happened on the pile up there, and they called it.
You'll see Bob Terrio coming over from the far side, number 45. He's hit.
That's it, right there, Al.
Right
when
there.
Wallin goes on top of him, the 15 yards. Overthrowing Al Coffey. Buddy Lee overshoots him. We're piling on. 15 yards. That takes the ball down inside the 30 to the 34-yard line. It is now second down and 10. There's Burt Jones along the sideline. Both Charlie McLendon and Bob Devaney will use two quarterbacks, will use many different sets of backs. They alternate, perhaps, Al, more than any other two teams on the same field that I can recall. They play everybody. Coffey is to the left, Hamilton to the right, second down 10. Buddy Lee in a crowd, throwing, and has his man for the first time tonight, Ken Cavanaugh Jr. Down near the 25-yard line at the 26. Dave Morock, the monster man, made the stop of the tight end, Cavanaugh.
And he got just great position on Morock. He doesn't have great speed, but was able to get downfield, hook, look in, and there it was.
22 seconds, clock running, third quarter, 10-6. Nebraska leading LSU. That is Ken Cavanaugh, Jr. Coffey slotted left. Hamilton is in that strong power eye backfield. And now flags go down. And they're pointing at somebody. Looked like they're pointing at Jimmy Elkins for jumping. And Charlie McLendon strides down the bench. Elkins is the left guard. And apparently Jimmy or somebody on that side raised up. And that is a legal procedure. Lee has now passed 17 times, completed 10 for 142 yards. 4 seconds to go. Hamilton has caught 6 of those passes for 94 yards.
Jim, the Bengals have knocked off 3 other teams in bowl games who came in undefeated.
Third down and 7. Buddy Lee looking for Coffey, who is deep. He's got to step on everybody. Touchdown!
What a move Al Coffey puts on Jim Anderson, number 18. There he is, wide open.
Mark Lumpkin, his extra point try is off to the side, and in this day of field goal kickers and with a fine one like Paul Rogers for Nebraska, that could be an important point. That's the end of the third quarter in the 1971 exciting Orange Bowl game with a score LSU 12, Nebraska 10. And now we return to our studios for this message. This is Jim Simpson with Aldi Regattas, the fourth quarter. If Nebraska can win this ball game, it will lay claim to the national championship. But LSU has other ideas. Mark Lumpkin will kick off to Rogers and Kenny. Along the ground, picked up by one of the upmen, Jim Karstens, a fullback, and he gets back across the 30-yard line, and it'll be first and 10 for the Big Red of Nebraska from there.
Jim, in 1963 Cotton Bowl, Texas came in undefeated, and they were beaten by LSU 13-0. And again in the Cotton Bowl in 1966, Arkansas came in undefeated, and they lost 14-7. In 1968 in the Sugar Bowl, Wyoming came in undefeated, and they lost to LSU 20-13. And here, LSU leads Nebraska undefeated 12-10.
Arduna is in as the man at the back of that I formation with Shorey up close. Arduna with that quick cut gets out near the 40-yard line. Gee, what a back he is. Everybody from Nebraska says so, and I can see it tonight. Cassio makes the tackle. Well, we'll repeat ourselves again. But how about Ohio State, knowing that Texas had been beaten by Notre Dame, realizing if it beat Stanford, it would be number one. But Ohio State lost. Nebraska knows if it can win tonight, it can lay claim to number one. But drama, and it looks as though Jerry List, and he's mad at himself, just simply charged off sides. The tight end, number 85. And there's the call.
And right now, Jim, the Nebraska team is a bit frustrated. They've gotten all their points, as you mentioned, in the first quarter. LSU has hung in there and fought like Tigers, and they've taken it away. The Cornhuskers need a big play, and you have the feeling if it's going to come, it'll come from Johnny Rogers or probably Guy Engels.
Arduno's carried 8 times for 43 yards. 14:22 to go in the ball game. Second down and 9. The ball on the 34-yard line of Nebraska. Guy Engels goes to the left. Johnny Rogers is also slotted left. And that is Joe Arduna. Taggy now is going to run, and he's got a lot of room to run, and gets across the 45-yard line. He's got a first down. Norsworthy came up to make the tackle, along with Sage and Cassio. LSU has been allowing an average of only 52 yards on the ground per ball game, and for 2 years in a row have led the nation against the rush. But Taggy is having good success tonight. Engels comes to the right. Arduna straight ahead. Lost the football. Belongs to Nebraska. John Sage throws up his hands, but I've got to believe, Al, that perhaps the whistle had blown before the ball popped loose.
Here's a quick one. There's Arduna in that deep set. The handoff, he's got it. He got hit.
Second down, tagging. Now throws. Has his man Shorey, who really gets belted at the 45-yard line. Make that Snice, beg your pardon. At the 45-yard line. Fry and Davis. Dan Snice, as Al said early in the ball game, does not have great speed, the offensive captain, but can surely catch the ball. And he has caught the ball for 2 touchdowns and the 18 catches he had this season before tonight. Engels to the left. Rogers slotted left. Quick pitch, that is Arduna, and he's got speed. Snice throws a fine block out in front of him, and he is tripped up by Casanova as he goes by and falls forward for the first down down near the 37-yard line.
And the thing that broke it, you called, Schneis, 22, makes a great block on Casanova. It looked like Casanova tripped him right there.
12-10, LSU, 12 and a half minutes to go in the ballgame. A record crowd of 80,699 in the Orange Bowl. The ball is at the 37 of LSU, first and 10, Nebraska. Hey, Nagy throws. Rodgers has the football. Norsworthy throws him down, but he's inside the 30, down to the 28-yard line. They'll mark it closer to the 27, and that's going to necessitate a measurement.
And I'm sure, Jim, Jeff Kenny's coming in, Orduna's going out. I'm sure that pass to Dan Schneis, 22, will not be put away. The middle has been open, so we might look for 22.
The measurement, Taggy right there looking, and he's going to be that short. But here again, Al, you so often love to call these things. That was a first down play, so now he is going to have second down, a little time in which to gamble if he wishes, because it's second down and very short yardage.
Right, Jim, it's a good opportunity to gamble. However, Taggy, in the gambling situation, seems to come more with the option and keep it himself.
Well, the nose of the ball just on the 27. Arjuna's carried 10 times. He's got a 5-yard average, 50 yards. It's Kenny that's in there now. This time, Taggy, the quarterback sneak, gets down to the 25. First down, Nebraska. 12-10 the score, LSU. They missed an extra point. And with a kicker like Paul Rogers, the Big Red of Nebraska certainly is climbing within field goal range.
I think we find, Jim, that statistically, that most times a team comes back after they have been stung. After a team has scored on them, they generally come back with a good march. That shows the class of a team.
And that shows you Joe Orduna looking on. First down play, and Kinney only gets about a yard. Mike Anderson, number 45, and number 41, Pepper Rutland, who was in the ball game, made the stop. Second down and 9. Clock continues to run, 11:20 to go. That is a defensive end over there, John Atkins. The one that we told you wears the glasses. See them? Doesn't wear contacts, wears glasses. Nice. And Orduna, the setback. Nagy rolling left. Steps around one man, and now Milliken gets him. Taggy that time rolled to the left, started to throw. Milliken jumped high in the air. So he didn't throw, stepped around him. He was slowed up, and Milliken came back to make the tackle. Sage was the man helping out Buddy Milliken. The ball is now on the 23-yard line. It'll be third down and 7, and here comes Jeff Kinney.
Here's a great situation again for the Dan Schneis play, or possibility to go to number 85. Go not too much to the obvious, 85 being Jerry Liss.
Rodgers comes way wide to the right. Third down. Taggy looking, Taggy throwing, has his man, Kinney, and Kinney is inside the 10-yard line down to the 5, where Norsworthy makes the stop, and Nebraska is right back in business with the ball at the 4.
It was a beautiful play. Kinney waited for everything to clear out. The deep zone developed. He was wide open underneath.
You also saw Nagel over there helping out on the saving tackle. First and goal to go. We've got 10 minutes left in the ball game. 12-10 LSU, but here comes Nebraska sending Ingles to the left. This is Kinney picking up important yard. He's still on his feet, and John Sage knocks him back, number 73. Milliken was hanging on, but Sage had to come up and bump him. Burns also in on the tackle. Well, they don't score many touchdowns against LSU rushing, but Nebraska already has scored one tonight and is threatening to do so again. Very quickly, Bobby Joe King tries to check in but can't, so he leaves the field. Now they're going to call time to allow Bobby Joe King to get in. On second down, with the ball just over the 2-yard line, as Jerry Taggy goes back to his coach, Bob Devaney, to ask what it is he should do. Well, Al, when you come to the Orange Bowl, it is always an exciting game and a fine pageant, and our action will continue at the Orange Bowl with the score. LSU 12, Nebraska 10. LSU has been giving up an average of 52 yards per game on the ground. They've already given up to three men 130 yards. They gave up two touchdowns rushing all season. They've given up one tonight. And who knows what's going to happen here? Perhaps a second. Nagy tries and does not get the touchdown. Matter of fact, when Tulane scored against LSU on the ground, it took him five downs. There was a penalty in there.
You recall in the last touchdown that Orduna made, Luis Casio, 48. And we indicated that the goal line defense of LSU is a bit different. Este will line up head on the center. Casio goes and he lines head up on the guard. It's a tough assignment for a linebacker.
Bob Newton, that All-American tackle, is on the left side. Kinney is the tailback they usually give to, and it's Taggy who gets it over. Simply reaches the ball over, and Nebraska goes in front.
Here it is. There he's going over the top, and now watch him reach out.
Nebraska looking for that number one ranking. Bob Devaney, their coach, said, I voted for my team every week. Paul Rogers in to do the kicking. Brownson is holding, and the kick is good. Now with 8 minutes and 50 seconds to go, time is out. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl with the score. Nebraska 17, LSU 12. We have 8 minutes and 50 seconds to go. Paul Rogers walks back to kick off to Casanova, the deep man. Ledoux number one and Coffey number three are there. And remember, they like to reverse or hand off the ball on a kickoff if they get the opportunity. And they can really fly. Now Casanova is watching Coffey take the football. Coffey still has the football. And Coffey is dragged down by Blahawk as he gets to the 15, the 16-yard line. First and 10 for LSU.
Now, we had mentioned that Nebraska, when they were stung, showed the class that they're made of that brought them to an undefeated record. And now LSU has been stung, a very big offensive series for the Tigers.
Buddy Lee is the quarterback. He's 11 for 18, 173 yards. The ball is on the 16-yard line. LSU down by five. Gagley comes to the left. Hamilton goes to the right. That is Danton picking up yardage. Remember Arthur Cantrell, who gained 892 yards this year, hurt his right ankle in the first quarter and has hardly seen any action at all. Carried the ball, I believe, three times for a total of about 5 yards and was hurt, and that was it. And LSU builds much of its offense, or built much of its offense, around its tailback, particularly Cantrell. Now it is Danton who is in there. Lee on second down, throwing downfield, could be intercepted, knocked away. Cush and Blahawk were there. Blahawk is furious. It was intended for Kegley, but they kind of collided with one another. So it'll be third down and seven.
The LSU team now is rolling to the strong side. Nebraska is. If LSU is flooding an area, Nebraska will flow to that side. The possibility again of coming back to the weak side remains a big one. Coffey has gone back in, Al Coffey number three, and he showed you how he can move.
And Steve Martin has come in to block at left guard. Third down, seven play. Buddy Lee back. Buddy Lee looking for Coffey. He has got him at the 25. He's out near the 27 and very near a first down. This measurement will be an important one for LSU and, of course, for Nebraska. And I'm sure we're going to have a measurement. Now they're looking. No, I'm not, because he says that is simply enough. First down, LSU.
Jimmy Anderson very wisely gave Coffey some room. The short area was open. Here it is, the ground level. Good move. He could be, Jim, setting up that fly pattern to number three.
Buddy Lee, and there goes Danton again across the 30-yard line, out to the 35, the 36-yard line. Dragged down by Morock with help from Bill Cush. Jay Michelson making a nice block to clear the way. It'll be second down and short yardage. And now, in this case, we'll see what Buddy Lee does. with second down and a little bit more than a yard to go. He sends Hamilton to the right, Coffey to the left. That's the square of the ball, 17 down for 66 yards. Danton goes for the first down, up near the 40-yard line. 7:15 to go. Nebraska leads it by 5, 17-12.
Right now, again, one of the better marches in this half, by the way. LSU has just done an outstanding job. But Jim Anderson is very much concerned about Al Coffey. He's giving him an awful lot of room short. LSU can complete it short to Coffey.
That's Steve Martin, who went in moments ago for Jimmy Elkins, the left guard. And he's out, and Elkins is back in. Pass intended for Coffey. Incomplete. The crowd is yelling. To many, it looked as though Willie Harper had jumped offside. Pass was marked incomplete.
You do have the feeling, Jim, the way Anderson is playing Coffey, that that could be the big situation of this Orange Bowl.
Second down and 10, 6:50 to go. Coffey comes out here again. Remember what Al has said. Let's see if it develops. Jim Anderson laying off him. Lee rolling, looking for Coffey, who is going deep. Off the fingertips of Anderson. They were looking to him, Al, but it is third down and 10.
That time, the monster man, Morrock, coming from the strong side, was doubling short. He took the short area, and Jim Anderson, who made a fine play, took it deep.
Ball is near the 39-yard line of LSU. This is a third down 10 situation for the Tigers. Or else he'll have to give the ball back to Nebraska, which leads by 5. Hamilton goes to the right, Coffey to the left. And Buddy Lee looking to throw, and it is tipped at the line of scrimmage, intended for Hamilton. It is fourth down, and LSU will have to kick the ball away. That is Buddy Lee very slowly getting up. Willie Harper, who has had a great evening, came in and laced Lee just as he released the ball. So it is fourth down and 10, and Buddy is coming out. Remember, he hurt his right arm, or hand, I should say, during practice. Johnny Rogers, like several on LSU. Oh, that was almost blocked. Willie Harper hit and knocked the man down. But they're saying that it was in an attempt to block the ball, and he hit the ball. And the ball will be spotted down at the 42-yard line. They told us so much about Willie Harper. 6'3", 205 pounds, a sophomore lineman of the year in the Big 8. He came in, did get a piece of the ball, knocked down the kicker, but since he got the ball, that's all right. And the ball goes out of bounds on the 43. And now Nebraska, looking for that claim for the national championship, can really get moving from the LSU 43. We'll see that in a moment as action will continue at the Orange Bowl with the score. Nebraska 17 and LSU 12. With Aldi Regattas, this is Jim Simpson at the Orange Bowl. And that is Burt Jones, quarterback. Buddy Lee was hurt, but the ball belongs to Nebraska. With the clock in its favor, 6:29 to go, and its quarterback, Jerry Tagge, having quite a night. 11 for 22 and 137 yards. He scored a touchdown, and he is the leading rusher in the game with 53 yards. Rogers in motion, Tagge with the football. Tagge gets it away, intended for Dan Snice, incomplete at the 40-yard line. It is second down and 10. Cassio was pressuring. There he is, number 48, Tagge.
Not that 17-12, Jim, is a substantial margin, but you had the feeling that possibly Tagge would keep it on the ground, try to grind out some first downs and run out some of the 6 minutes and 23 seconds to go.
Well, again, a couple of years ago, it wasn't all over until after the gun sounded with the 12 men on the field. So this game with 6:23 to go out, who knows? That's Tagge pitching back to Rogers. Rogers trying to get down the sideline, and that very quick LSU defense closed with Louis Cassio leading the way, number 48. Johnny Nagel also over there. The ball gets back to the 40-yard line, and it'll be third down and 7.5 yards to go. The clock has been stopped at 6:17. Lloyd Frye races in with the defensive play.
Woody Cox raced in with the offensive play, number 32.
Third down play. Rogers in motion. Taggy being blitzed. Gets the ball away. It is caught. Coming out of the backfield is, well, that's the tight end, List. And the ball is on the 25-yard line. And that is enough for the first down.
And Taggy's not going to make many third down plays that'll be more significant than that one.
Well, I started to say, Al, the game is far from being over. List, who jumped offside once and was thrown too deep twice in the first quarter, made the great catch there. But I'm sure that the folks in the press box at this moment, when looking for the most valuable player, would be considering Taggy of Nebraska as well as Harper of Nebraska. LSU's Andy Hamilton is at quarterback, and Buddy Lee before being injured. Kinney barreling into the line, picking up a yard or two. And that is all. 5:45 to go, and we'll give you more and more how that clock is running in this 17-12 ball game, which Nebraska is leading.
Again, Taggy has been running very well, although, as you commented, he nor Van Bronson have been much running this year, but that option play has been working, so we'll be looking for a little of that from number 14.
Arduna, number 31, has come back in. Rogers wide. Well, he's slotted right, and Ingles is wide to the right. This is Arduna cutting inside. Cassio is the first to hit him. Casanova is the man who made the stop. And Dan Snice, for the second or third time that we can remember this evening, really put a block, enabling Arduna to shake free. The ball is at the 16-yard line. It is now third, another third down situation with 2 yards to go. 4:50 left. Ingles to the left. This is Arduna, and he is very close to that first down and may have it. Across the 15-yard line, first down for Nebraska.
And number 74, Bob Newton, the All-American, playing that side. Let's take a look and see as he moves off that ball, driving the man to the outside. Number 77, Dick Rupert, putting a fine block on Cassio, and there's Arduna. Makes it easy when that left tackle and left guard put those kinds of blocks on.
Arduna now has 60 yards and 12 carries. Taggy hands to Arduna again, who picks up a yard or so down near the 12-yard line. Ball is free, and LSU recovers. Looks like Piku recovered the football. Well, you are almost, many of you, I'm sure, writing off LSU, saying Nebraska was moving in, but with 4:09 left, 17-12 the score, Richard Piku, the man we feel, got that fumble. Let's look again, Al.
There it is in slow motion. Mike Anderson's coming up. It's hard to see who gets the fumble. They're all barreling on. Mike Anderson was awfully close to it. Piku, 88. Dave Piku.
Jones is in there. Hands off to Danton. Danton hurdles and gets out across the 15-yard line. Picks up 5 yards. Chris Danton. We pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC television network. .350 to go, second down, 5. Jones, looking for Kegley, has him, steps out of bounds, first down across the 25. Over there, guarding against him, was Terrio. Got by Anderson, and Terrio had to knock him out of bounds. First down from the 26. 17-12. Texas was beaten today. Ohio State was beaten today. Nebraska wants to win this one, and so does LSU. Jones looking in trouble, and Perriard is the first there. When little Ed Perriard makes the tackle, he gets up and really punches at the air.
On that play, the LSU Tigers had a triple to the right side. Two men slotted inside, a man wide, an obvious pass, and the big rush came, Again, LSU has gotten off a couple of good screens. We might look for it.
3:10 to go and counting. Second down and 18. Remember the Gator Bowl tomorrow. Auburn and Ole Miss at 2 o'clock on NBC. Right now we're concerned with the Orange Bowl. Jones. Now he's going to run out of time and he's going to be thrown again. Jones sits there. This time it is Atkins, the left defensive end, and he has been thrown for big losses tonight. Buddy Lee went out injured, the senior quarterback, and it's been up to Burke, who is a sophomore.
Here it is from the end zone. You see Perriard working on the center, but you'll see 57 come in with the big rush. Again, the triple to the right. He could find no receivers. John Atkins makes a fine play.
Well, here's a play. Third down and 30 yards to go. 2:20 left. 17-12 LSU. Charlie McLendon of LSU upset. Jones going back. Can't hang on. He's on his own end zone there. Throws down the sidelines. Hamilton. He's got it. At the 37 or 8 yard line. Enough for the first down. Burt Jones comes up with a big play to his cousin, Andy Hamilton.
Not a bad play, the cousin. It was wide open. He made it right there.
2 minutes and 7 seconds to go. Coffey comes to the left. LSU has new life. Nebraska hanging on. Jones throws again to the sidelines. Hamilton steps out of bounds. A pickup out to the 44. Well, W. Keith Phillips, Jr., this year's president of the Orange Bowl Committee, has put on quite a game. Our executive vice president, creator of the pageant, Ernie Siler, we wish to thank him, his aides, Dan McNamara and Hal Fleming, Jack Hodling, the public relations director, and of course our thanks to the athletic director and head coach Bob Devaney of Nebraska, the athletic director Carl Maddox of LSU and his head coach Charlie McLendon, and the sports information directors. I'll give you the names in a moment. Second down play. Danton trips as he gets nearer first down. Don Bryant of Nebraska is the sports information director there, and Bud Johnson of LSU. And I'm sure if you talk to any of them now, they don't want to talk to us. Now, very quickly, we're calling timeout for LSU. 1 minute, 48 seconds to go, 17-12. And before you have a word, Al, our spotters have been Dave Blackwell for Nebraska and Don Kennard for LSU. Bob Sheridan handles our statistics. Our stage managers, Huey McDermott and Ed Prendergast. And now Al. And even you, let's see, they're going to measure here. They're going to measure, and they are that short. But LSU has called timeout. So action will continue at the Orange Bowl with the score, Nebraska 17 and LSU 12. Nebraska has that much time to hang on and lay claim to a national championship. LSU has that much time, 1 minute 48 seconds, to upset the Big Red of Nebraska. It's a third down and one play. And Jones goes for the first down. Burt Jones, the quarterback, and they may have to measure again. We'll see where they spot the football. First down for LSU.
Depending on what LSU does, obviously, in this drive, one of the big plays of this football game could have been that pass from Jones in that third and 33 to his cousin Andy Hamilton. What a big play that was.
Hamilton right, Kegley left. Jones back to throw. Looking, throws for his cousin Hamilton, and he's out of bounds when he caught the football. That stops the clock with 1 minute and 37 seconds to go. Well, I can remember the first nighttime Orange Bowl, January 1st, 1965, when I was here, and Alabama, number one ranked in Texas, played. Joe Namath last year at Alabama. That was a great football game. I can remember Oklahoma being way out in front of favorite Tennessee and then had to hang on to win. The great finish between Penn State and Kansas. And now LSU, Nebraska. Coffey and Kegley are the receivers. Jones taking his time, and he is in a crowd again, and he's down again. Now the ball is picked up by Willie Harper, and down he goes, and it belongs to Nebraska. Harper just took the ball away. Tom Jones, who went into that crowd, and apparently the sophomore Harper went in after it. Here it is again. Let's watch closer.
Willie just pulls it out of his arms and runs away with it. There he is, pulling it away from him. There's no fumble. He's a fighter. They never do get him down.
The ball is on the 43-yard line. Texas lost, Ohio State lost. Nebraska figures if they beat LSU, they should be claimed number one, and you'll hear that chant. And Taggy's just going to run that clock as he falls down, 1:15 and counting. Nebraska got 10 points in the first quarter. Seven of those set up on a fumble at the 15-yard line. But they didn't score again, as in the third quarter, LSU moved ahead 12-10. Taggy went over from the one here in the fourth quarter to make it 17-12.
And, Jim, we're just not going to see many better football games from many aspects. The offensive lines of both teams have done a fine job. The defensive units, both teams have been just superb. When you think of the size of Nebraska, the fact that LSU is not quite as big but has hung in there, constantly hung in there, they've done a great job. So this is an Orange Bowl to remember.
Second down and nine. 1 minute, 11 seconds to go. LSU had given up two touchdowns on the ground this season. They have given up two touchdowns on the ground tonight against a big and powerful Nebraska team. As Al said, they have hung in there, but right now they're trailing by 5 points. Second down, nine. That is Kinney getting across the 40-yard line and down to the 39-yard line. Clock is running. And now LSU stops the clock with 1 minute exactly left. Well, our reminder again that the Gator Bowl is coming up tomorrow at 2 o'clock. Auburn with Pat Sullivan, a fine quarterback. Ole Miss with Archie Manning, a fine quarterback. The teams on that one at 2 o'clock Eastern time. And a week from tomorrow, Al and I will be over in Mobile, Alabama for the Senior Bowl game from Ladd Stadium there. Of course, our Super Bowl weekend, January 16th and 17th, Bing Crosby Golf, and of course, the Super Bowl. This Sunday, we have the American Football Conference game. And with third down and six, now they say they're number one.
Well, they might be, and they cannot afford any kind of a mistake right now. And you'll notice, Jim, every time the ball is handed off to Jeff Kinney, number 35, the one thing he's thinking about is wrapping it up. He's covering it with both hands.
Third down and six. LSU still has a chance. They have striking power if they can stop Nebraska. Taggy keeps the ball. Pursued, the ball is loose across the field and belongs to LSU with 52 seconds left at the 40-yard line. Buddy Milliken, I believe, recovered the ball, number 86, in the lower left-hand corner of your picture. It's not over yet.
And the LSU team does the thing you're supposed to do. They went for the arms, trying to pull the ball away. There it is.
And that's Milliken on the football. Arthur Davis shook it loose. Burt Jones is back under a tremendous rush. Steps up, throws, and it is intercepted by number 45, Bob Terrio. Nebraska gets it back with 45 seconds left. Intended for Andy Hamilton, the ball is at the 38-yard line. Now LSU looking for lightning to strike twice.
I doubt whether it'll strike. I have the feeling that Jerry Taggy will probably try three or four quarterback sneaks. Use up any timeouts and just try to kill the clock that way.
Engels is to the left. Rogers slotted left. Taggy goes down to one knee. Tennessee 34, Air Force 13. That was the final in the Sugar Bowl this afternoon in New Orleans. Notre Dame did quite a job on the University of Texas, number one ranked, that had been the top scoring team in the nation. Notre Dame beat them 24-11. That set the stage for Ohio State to grab the number one ranking. But Stanford and Jim Plunkett beat Ohio State 27-17. Nebraska, third ranked in the nation, 10-0-1. If it wins tonight, we'll certainly say we are number one. They've got 14 seconds to go. The clock is running. Kenny is saying we're number one. It's going to run out. LSU is out of timeouts. Nebraska, after Texas and Ohio State loses, wins. Now, Charlie McLendon, I know, is disappointed as he runs after Bob Devaney of Nebraska, but I am sure that Charlie McLendon will go home, as will Bob Devaney, knowing that this was one of the finest collegiate bowl games we have seen in many, many years. And Al, we cannot leave this scene without a few final words from you.
Well, this is one kind of a football game, Jim, when both teams must be terribly proud. Baton Rouge, you could be awfully proud, and I'm sure Lincoln, Nebraska must just feel great.
All right, once again, the final score, Nebraska 17, could be number one. LSU, a great battle, 12.